Well, hey there, everybody. Today we're going to be making this really beautiful 3D layered hummingbird paper craft here. Let's go over the supplies you're going to need for this craft. This design that you're seeing here, this is available for you below. It is linked so you can download it below, and I hope you will enjoy it. It's super pretty to make. You could put these into shadow boxes onto wood signs like this, or just use it in any other way you would like. So the supplies you're going to need for this project, first and foremost, is a Cricut machine. Because we're dealing with something very intricate here, you will want the assistance of a cutting machine. I am using a Cricut Maker 3, but you could absolutely use any series of the Maker, any series of the Explorer to create this craft. I don't recommend the Joy for this particular Mandala craft just because of the intricate nature of it. Having to go too small within the capacity of what the Joy can cut, it may not result in a very nice clean cut. You're more than welcome to try it. But for best results, I recommend a full-size machine. You'll also need to have a Cricut mat. You can use a green mat, or you can use the light grip mat, which is blue. The green mat, if you use that, I recommend making sure that it is maybe a mat you've already used so that you're not ending up ripping your paper because it's so sticky. Otherwise, I'd opt for the light blue mat. I'm gonna be using foam strip tape to layer these paper layers together here, as well as some liquid glue. So this is Tombow liquid glue. You can use lots of other paper crafting liquid glues as well, and that's perfectly fine. And this is 3D foam strip tape, and I'm gonna link my resources below for you. I also have a weeding tool in hand in order to get the backs of my tape off nice and easy. I have a brayer tool to help push my material to my mat, and I also have a pair of scissors here to trim down some of my foam strip tape. Now for the main component of our supplies, you're going to need to have some cardstock. So this hummingbird and flowers is made 100% out of paper cardstock. I have used lots of different brands of cardstock before, and I have many resources below that I will link for my blog, from my blog, but this brand that I am featuring here today is by the 12x12 cardstock shop. And I have fallen in love with their paper there because it cuts so beautifully on the Cricut, even when you're dealing with more intricate cuts like this project here. So make sure you check out the 12x12 cardstock shop because they are really wonderful. They have tons of different colors, sizes, and thicknesses of paper. I recommend 65-pound to 80-pound cardstock for this particular project. I don't recommend going much lighter than 65 pound though, because you may not have the stiffness you need in the paper in order to get a good result. I'm going to be using a variety of vibrant colors here, but feel free to pick whatever colors work well for you. These are just a few of the many, many colors that the 12x12 cardstock shop features on their site. They have completely smooth paper cardstock, solid core, or they have some really pretty textured cardstock as well. It's hard to see on camera, but these two here have a very slight texture to them, all solid core, and they work really well with the Cricut machine. I was really impressed with them. So make sure you check that out below, and let's go ahead and get started on this beautiful craft.
All right, so I have my design here loaded up in Cricut Design Space. Again, you can find more information about how to download these templates below if you want to use this beautiful hummingbird and flower Mandala layered craft here. If you've never uploaded your own SVG files to Cricut before, make sure you visit the video that is linked below in the video description. I will walk you through how to use the upload button over here on your left-hand side to browse your computer and to bring in your own SVG files to Cricut. So make sure you follow that below if you've never uploaded your own file and you need additional help with that. Once you've brought this file in, there's just a couple things you want to think about. First is your size. I do not recommend, due to the intricate nature of this, going too small. So for example, my hummingbird here is a little over 7.7 inches wide and 8.6 inches high. This turned out really well. You may be able to go about an inch smaller or so, maybe 2 inches, but I would not go super small. So just keep that in mind. My flowers here are measuring approximately, let's see, these are measuring 6.2 by 4.7. So of course you can play around with, like, you know, the rotation of it and everything like that. That's the size I went with for my flowers. Again, up to you, but don't go too small on that. If you want to change the colors, maybe these are not your colors and this is not your taste, then feel free to select the layers over here in the layers panel, and you can come up to the color swatch here next to the operation tab. and you can change any of the colors you want. So maybe you want your hummingbird to have like reds in it, reds and pinks instead of blues. You could come in here and you could change out all of these colors and make them completely different and go a route like that, for example. And that way you can help visualize your project. So I'm very much a blue, teal, turquoise, and pink girl. So this works for me, but that is how you would change that there as well. Once you've scaled and you've decided on your colors for your paper, go ahead and just click on the Make It button. It's going to sort everything by color. If you're using 12 by 12, you can leave that there. If not, go ahead and change it to like 8.5 by 11, which is another popular size. Click continue to connect to your Cricut machine. I'm using a Maker 3, but like I said earlier, you can use any of the full size machines. They will work just fine. We're gonna be using cardstock for intricate cuts in this project. Cardstock for intricate cuts is extremely crucial when you're dealing with cuts of this nature, where there's lots of little curves and small cutouts and all of that. Pretty much anytime you're working with a layered Mandala type of project, when there are loads of them out there, you're gonna want to stay with the cardstock for intricate cuts. The cardstock for intricate cuts does take longer than your traditional medium cardstock setting or your light cardstock setting, because it actually goes over each of the cuts two times. So instead of just cutting this shape out once, it's gonna go one time and then it's gonna go around it a second time. And the reason that works is because it doesn't have to put as much pressure on the paper and therefore it's not as prone to tearing. So if you're experiencing tearing with your paper, try out cardstock for intricate cuts. It's something that I use quite often, so I've favored it. I have it as my favorites here in my material settings in Design Space. Let's go ahead and cut this project out and start assembling.
So I've already got my design loaded up and we're gonna go ahead and place our first piece of cardstock on our mat here. Again, make sure the mat is relatively sticky. You wanna make sure nothing is minorly shifting. Even if it doesn't look like it's shifting, sometimes just the fact that if the paper's lifting in certain places, that can cause tearing as well. I love to use a brayer tool, especially when working with cardstock for intricate cuts, because you're really getting that material pressed onto the mat. And the more stable and secure it is, the better chance your cuts are going to come out beautifully. So something to think about is having this brayer tool on hand. I'll link the resources below for you if you want to know where I get mine. This one's just by Cricut. So I'm going to go ahead and load this into my Cricut machine here, pressing the double arrow flashing button to load the mat. And like I said, I have cardstock for intricate cut settings selected in Cricut Design Space. So make sure to give that setting a try. There are some cases where you can get away with light cardstock setting and medium cardstock setting, but I find for projects of this nature, cardstock for intricate cuts is going to be your best friend. Once your mat is loaded, go ahead and press the flashing go button. This may look like a play icon or a Cricut icon. This is going to flash to tell you, press this go button to proceed with cutting your design. All right, so one of our first cuts is done here. I'm gonna unload this. When you're working with cardstock in general, it is wise to flip the mat over and to peel the mat away from the material. It's gonna help eliminate the curling and it's gonna work out a lot better for you. So now we have our design on our mat. I'm still going to work it away slowly and carefully from the mat. These are intricate. So go nice and slow. If you're using a green mat for the intricate pieces, make sure it's a mat that's not fresh, it's been used before. Otherwise, this may tear. If you have only fresh mats on hand and opt for the light blue one, that one's going to work very well for you. All right, there is our hummingbird cutout, our first one there. It turned out really beautiful. The cardstock for intricate cuts did exactly what it needed to do. One little piece there hanging on, there we go. All right, so that was one of the most intricate cuts of this entire hummingbird design. So we can see that turned out rather well. I'm gonna go ahead and proceed and cut out the rest of these colors of cardstock. All right, so I have my hummingbird cut out here as well as my flower. I've already done two of the flowers here. You can see how they turned out. And we're gonna go ahead and just layer these together. So in order to layer these, you're going to want some glue and you're also going to want some 3D foam tape as well. I'm gonna link my resources for this below, but both are handy to have on hand because with the more intricate, delicate layers, the glue is gonna work better than the foam strip tape. Okay, and we're gonna start with the flower first and then we'll move on to the hummingbird design. So make sure you get all of your layers assembled correctly. Just double check that everything is on top of the layer it's supposed to be. And you can use the SVG file as guidance in Cricut Design Space. So I have mine ready to go there. I'm gonna go ahead and flip this over and then take this second one here. And I'm going to be using the foam strip tape for this layer. All I'm going to do here is grab a pair of scissors and trim down. Now with these designs, they are very intricate in nature. So I have made both of these without putting any tape on the outer edges here. I just put it on the center. You can work some tape in here if you would like to, if you cut very small pieces and just sort of dot it along the edge, you can make that work without it showing through the other side. That's really up to your preference. I'll give you an example here, but you don't want to do too much because otherwise it's going to show through when we flip it over. There we go. We could do little dots like that of this tape on the tip if we would like. I'm not too concerned with it. I haven't had any issues. So I'm just going to do the center part here. I'm going to use my weeding tool to pull the backs of my tape off here. And then just take a second to line this up. All right, and we're gonna move on to the next layer here. So for this green layer in my case here, I'm gonna actually use glue for this layer. So I'm using this Tombow liquid glue here and has a precision tip, which I love, because it really helps just me dot the glue where it needs to go. And then we're going to place it straight down on top of this layer. And if you don't want to use foam strip tape for any of this and you just want to do glue, that's perfectly fine as well. It'll still turn out beautiful. So don't get hung up on that. So for this layer, I actually use the foam strip tape again because it has that center area where we can layer our tape in here without a lot of trouble. And then again, if you want to trim down some really small pieces that you can add to the tips here, you're welcome to do that. I have also done it without it and been okay as well. Okay, so I'm placing this next layer down here. I'm just gonna press that on. And then for this very last layer, I am gonna use glue on this one as well. So I'm gonna take my glue again and just go around and dot it. Okay, and so I'm just pressing this final layer down here. There we go. And we'll just go ahead and set this aside to dry for a few minutes while the glue sets up on those layers that we use the glue. So I've got my three cute little flowers there. And now we're gonna work on our hummingbird. Again, I've checked that all my layers are in the correct order. I've got them ready to go. I'm gonna go ahead and flip them over here. And I'm gonna grab my foam strip tape and start working that onto the design here. Again, you're gonna wanna trim down some pieces. All All right, so I'm gonna do the exact same thing here as I did with the flowers. We're just going to get these lined up, place them down. All right, so I'm gonna move on to this layer here, flip that over. And I'm gonna need to trim down some small pieces here and work those on. So working these on, if this is too difficult for you after the first layer, by all means, go ahead and use glue. It's completely fine. If you're going much smaller than I am, finding areas to stick the foam strip tape is going to be very challenging. This is about a 7.5 inch in size here for our hummingbird that I did. So there's just enough space that I can work these on. All right, now after the third layer, you will want to move to glue. This does get a little bit more tricky. You're welcome to try the foam strip tape. You might be able to get away with it on this layer, the second to last one. I'm gonna go ahead and move to glue for the last two layers here. So I'm just gonna come in here and do just like we did with the flower. So I'm placing this layer on now. There we go. And then our final layer here, I'm going to also use glue on this. So I'm just placing my last piece here. Of course, we're going to let this dry completely for the layers we use glue on. And if you need to come back in here and add a little more glue anywhere, you can absolutely do that. Push these feathers down a little bit more here. All right, there we go. So our hummingbird is complete. Our flowers are complete. So I like to style this so that the hummingbird is surrounded by these pretty flowers, much like hummingbirds are in nature. All right, so you could style this in a shadow box. I'm actually gonna put it on this super cute little wood sign here. And all I'm gonna do is first decide how I want it displayed. So I think I'm gonna put the flowers kind of like that. And then we'll put our hummingbird in the middle there. And what I like to do is once I've decided that, I'll go ahead and use the foam strip tape to tape it to the sign. You could use hot glue also if you're more comfortable with that, but the foam strip tape is pretty sturdy, so I'm gonna go ahead and use that to place this on the sign. Plus, it's gonna be relatively easy enough that I could lift it off if I wanted to reuse the sign for something different in the future. All right, so our beautiful 3D layered hummingbird mandala craft is complete, and I put it here on the sign, but of course you could put it on other things as well, in a shadow box or something like that. If it was slightly smaller and you had maybe a larger card, you could even put it onto a card. So you can use these in a lot of different ways. It's a great project for getting your feet wet with layered paper craft projects, intricate cuts with your Cricut machine and testing that, trying out papers and settings and things like that. So this is a really great project for that. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Make sure you download these templates on members.abbykirstencollections.com, where you'll be able to find the layered SVG files there for all of our premium members. All right, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye for now.
If you enjoyed this tutorial, I hope to see you in my member vault. course, we offer many free things on Abbi Kirsten Collections, but I also have a premium member vault where you can access every design I have ever made. There is tons of seasonal crafts in there, Cricut tutorials, printables, cheat sheets, SVG files, and so much more waiting for you. So I hope you will hop on board with that. You can find all the information below, and there are loads of more creative ideas and tutorials waiting for you. We add new projects every single month, so there's always something new every time you log in. I hope to see you there. Bye for now.